we guys happened to wake up 10 minutes prior to the alarm, and surprisingly, Lawrence is up before 6. Good morning, Laurie.
I'm always up.
ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ತೆಗಿ ನೋಡೋಣ ಬೆಳಗಾಗಿದೆ ಇಲ್ವಾ ಆಚೆ ಅಂತ. ಓ ಸೂಪರ್
ಸೂಪರ್.
ಐ ಆಮ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಮೈ ಬ್ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ ಕಾಫಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಟಿ ಬ್ರೈಟ್ ಫಾರ್ 5:45 ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ದ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು The plan for the day is to visit Dhanushkodi, and after which we'll be coming back to the hotel and we'll take shower, and after which we'll be going to Ramnath Swami temple. It's one of the most sacred temple for Hindus. That's because of the Jyotirlingam which is there, and there's a quite a history behind this temple. One can Google because it's too too much for me to tell or make you understand. It was built in 12th century and it's known for its architecture. So we're going to visit the temple, and there's a lot to do in Rameshwaram. There is this lighthouse, and there are a couple of other very well-known places like Sita Teertham, Lakshman Teertham. So they're all basically holy and sacred places. All this have roots to the dates back to the time when Sita was kidnapped by Ravana. That was when Sri Rama came down south here and had to construct a Ram Setu. And that's how the bridge was made to Sri Lanka, and that's the same bridge which is here in Rameshwaram. So we're going to visit that place too, which is in Dhanushkodi. But apparently a couple of localites told us here that tourists are not being allowed yet due to COVID situation and all that. But when we inquired a few other people, they said there is another route which we can take. Let's see, fingers crossed. We have come so far to see that, and we'll be really disappointed if that doesn't happen. So stay tuned, guys. The way we parked, it looks like these guys were talking all night. Huh? So we'll be taking the Triumph Tiger to Dhanushkodi. So if possible, we'll be doing some off-road adventure stuff and all that. That's the plan. It's 7 a.m. now, and we are on our way to Dhanushkodi.
And we are going in a gully road, in fact.
Yeah, internal road. Because we were told at the Nakabandi that tourists are not allowed to Dhanushkodi, so we are trying our luck taking the alternative road. We are slightly disappointed because Dhanushkodi was closed. Apparently there was some suicide which happened, which took place early morning today. So, they didn't leave anybody through the check post. So we came back to the hotel. We thought we'll have breakfast and then probably we'll visit the temple. So that's the plan of action for the day. We're having breakfast and that's the menu. So we are going to Vellundi Teertham. It's a sweet water well. The story behind this place is Sita was thirsty and she wanted to drink water, and apparently since the sea water is too salty and it's not supposed to be, it's not consumable, Rama apparently happened to shoot an arrow from his bow the sand right next to the beach, which penetrated close to about 20 feet inside, and the water which came from the well was sweet. Ever since then, this water has been sweet, and people say that if you drink this water, it is holy and stuff. So let's go check it out, Florence. As I said, we are here at Velundi Teertham. That's the well which I just told you guys about. Perfect, guys, this is the second time I'm coming down to Rameshwaram. The previous time I came, it was with my wife. I think it was like 5 years ago. I would say the place is as is, it's untouched. Feeling nostalgic. I hope we'll get to taste the water. It was sweet the last time I had. Hopefully it's sweet now. As you can see, that's the ocean. And Lord Rama had fired a bow into this well. And the water, what you can see down, is supposed to be sweet. Due to COVID reasons, they are not. Sometimes, so probably after all this, you should come here and taste this water. It is pretty sweet. So we are planning to head to a couple of other temples after this. So stay tuned, guys. Just when I said they're not allowing us to have the water, the priest is walking towards us, and we might just get lucky. This is opposite Sita Teertham, where we can see the floating stone. So these are the stones on which Jai Siyaram was written and the bridge was made. This is the place where Sri Rama Teertham is. House of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Hi friends, we are going to the Ramnath Swami temple now. Morning we couldn't go. We took blessing from the God. The phones were not allowed inside, so I'm sorry I cannot show you the beauty of the temple, but it's definitely available in Google. Now we are heading to Agni Tirtham, which is right behind the temple. Now we are walking towards Agni Tirtham, which is right behind Ramnath Swami temple. We have actually reached. That's the place. And that's the ocean. Basically, people come here to leave the ashes. As per Hindu beliefs, it's believed very auspicious. The soul rests in peace. So, more or less, we have explored Rameshwaram to the max, and we have had a great day today. The only thing which we couldn't do is Dhanushkodi, and that was really unfortunate. So, we are giving it a last try tomorrow.
Yes. Of course.
Yeah, of course. It's worth giving it a try. So, if it happens, we are going to visit Dhanushkodi. Else, post breakfast, we are going to head to Kodaikanal. See you guys. Bye-bye.